than all of these other Hebrew Israelite camps. So we gotta be the men. Go ahead.
To recover the remnant of his people,
right,
that shall be left from Assyria and from Egypt and from Pathros,
uh-huh,
and from Cush,
uh-huh,
and from Elam,
uh-huh,
and from Shinar,
and from Shinar,
and from Hamath,
uh-huh,
and from the islands of the sea.
And from the islands of the sea. So these be the areas where our people are scattered abroad in. And the elect are going to be gathered from these areas and delivered from the destruction from the nuclear war. Because there will be indeed a nuclear war. There will be indeed a nuclear war. You have the Chinese, you have the Russians, okay? You have even the British, which has the a missile called the Brimstone. How prophetical is that? Great Britain has a missile named the Brimstone. You see this, people, right? So at the end of the day, there will be indeed a third world war, and in the midst of all of that, before that happens, or in the midst of it, or just or when it's about to happen, that's when the Lord is going to deliver his elect from the four winds of the earth. And the two-thirds of our own people, they're going to be destroyed, man. The ones who brought people that's into Islam, the ones who brought people that's into Rastafarianism, okay, the ones who brought people that are into Sodom and just activity. The Lord is going to destroy them, man. Go ahead. And recover his elect, go ahead.
Go, and he shall set up an ensign to the nation.
In other words, an example, go ahead.
And shall assemble the outcasts of Israel.
And shall assemble the outcasts of Israel, because well, our people have been outcasts out of their land. Like we're outcasts, because we're not in our land. The land that we need to be in is Jerusalem today. But what you have is you have another set of people, which are the wicked, which are the evil ones, gutter rats,
right?
Which go to destruct the Jews, right? They're the ones in that land. So that what the Lord is gonna do, the Lord is gonna get these jokers, these spiritual clowns, that's looking like Abraham Lincoln with them black hats and stuff like that, and get them involved in that nuclear war and destroy their asses right where they need to be. Okay? Put their asses in the freaking dirt, right? Because they don't need to be in that land, right? They messed up that whole land. And they got it looking strange, right? But what the Lord is going to do, the Lord is going to destroy those people and cleanse the land, and they're going to come back in that land. Go ahead.
And gather together the dispersed of Judah.
And gather together dispersed amongst Judah. Because you have, amongst Judah, you have the so-called blacks in America. You have the so-called Nigerian people, the Ghanaian people. Okay, you have the West Indians. You have the so-called Haitians. Okay, you have all of those people that are going to be gathered back. They make up the tribe of Judah. You are the tribe, you are the Judahites. Not those people with them black hats and stuff like that. No. We're the real Jews in the Bible, man. You are the Hebrew Israelites. Okay? You are the Hebrew Israelites. Go ahead.
The dispersed of Judah,
uh-huh,
are the four corners of the earth.
They're the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. That's why you, and when you understand the transatlantic slave trade, it goes according to the spore. This is the word spore means disperse. So we were dispersed from the four winds of the earth. Some of us went over there in the Middle East somewhere. Some of us went to India and all of that stuff, man. So that prophecy fits our people to a T. It doesn't fit those people over there that's called themselves the Jews, because they don't fit them curses. Go ahead. Oh, that's good on that. Okay, get back to, after that, get back to that.
Jeremiah 30, verse 11.
Uh-huh.
For I am with you, saith the Lord,
uh-huh,
to save you.
So the Lord is going to be with us to save us, man. The Heavenly Father is going to be with us to save us from the whole of this hell that's getting ready to happen. You see the signs that we've got? The Lord is going to save us from all of that that's going to come down. Okay? And that's what we doing, man. All we coming out here to do is to prophesy and to warn the people of things to come. That's all we're going to do, man. And if you can't understand that, then you can keep on walking. You know what I mean? We ain't going to try and have you understand what we're saying. If you can't get it, then that's on you. You know what I'm saying? And that goes to you so-called blacks out here. Alright?
So I make a full end of all nations, whether I am scattered you, yet will I not make a full end of thee.
For the Lord has made a full end to all nations, and that has happened throughout history, but the Lord will not make a full end of his people. The Lord ain't going to do that. Go ahead.
But I will correct thee in measure.
But the Lord will judge us accordingly. Go ahead.
I will not leave thee altogether unpunished.
Yeah, the Most High won't leave us in the state that we're in. You know, a lot of you people think that we're always going to be in the ghettos and all that stuff. That ain't going to happen no more, man. We're going to be living in mansions, man, made out of freaking gold, okay? And we're going to have all the other nations in captivity. That's what we got coming, man. And that's why we don't give a good goddamn what this damn devil does, man. Bring the martial law troops. Stop the freedom of speech. You know what I'm saying? Bring your little MRAPs around and all that, man. We don't give a damn about this society, man.
Everything
fuck this society,
everything,
man. Everything, I say that in the spirit of the Lord, man. Okay? Because this society is destined to fall. This society is not going to fit the form of shit, man. Okay? Go ahead.
Say, but thus saith the Lord, that bruise is incurable.
That bruise is incurable. That's talking about the 2/3 problem. You know, even though it judges by severity sin our people, but the Lord is still going to have mercy on us, dealing with the elect. But the Lord is going to get rid of the 2/3 of our people. The 66.6% of our people are going to be destroyed, man. By this martial law, by the chaos that's going to take place, the martial law is declared, the riots and all of that stuff, and then eventually the nuclear missiles are going to be the main weapon that's going to wipe the 2/3 of our people off the planet, man. Because them Russians got them, okay, them Iranians got them, all that stuff, man, it's getting ready to happen. China got them. Why they got these missiles anyway? Why, you know, why is it that they're doing practices, they're doing drills? Why are these superpower nations doing drills? Well, why are they doing that for? Because they're preparing, man. You know what I mean? You don't practice for no reason. You practice it because you know you're going to have to do that something that you're practicing. So these superpower nations are practicing their military might and their weaponry. Because they're going to use that weaponry. They're going to use those missiles. Go ahead.
They say, and thy wound is grievous. There is none to plead thy cause.
Yeah, so I mean, going back to our people, Jacob, I mean, our sins are severe, man. Our people did a lot of bad things, man. A lot of our people did a lot of wrong things, man. And this is why we wound up in slavery, man. This is why our enemies had us in captivity, because of our wrongdoing. But the Lord is still going to have mercy on his elect, though. And also, the Lord is going to have people that have destroyed our people. They're going to get payback for that, still. Okay, because the Lord has a thing with Israel, man. We're likening them to the apple of his eye. All right, we're the Lord's favorite people. So even though we went off and all of that stuff, the Lord loved us so much that he's still going to recover us. But he's just going to start with the elect. The majority of our people, they got to be destroyed. They got to go because they're too wicked. They're too damn wicked, man. They got to go. The Lord ain't going to bring them leaven in the kingdom. Go ahead.
There's none to plead thy cause,
that
thou mayest be bound up. Thou hast no healing medicine.
Right, because pretty much, man, Jake, you know, when you go where Jake is at, you can just see that Jake is just out, man. You know what I mean? You can look at our people, you can just see that there's no cure for them. They're done. You know when something is too destroyed, you can't use it no more, and have a car for example. You have a car, right, and the car's all messed up to the point where the engine's all jacked up, everything's all jacked up. You can't use that car no more. It's unusable. And that's the majority of our people, they're unusable. So the Lord is going to get rid of them. You see? So go ahead.
And it say, all thy lovers have forgotten thee. They seek thee not.
Yeah, they seek thee not. Go ahead.
For I have wounded thee with a wound of an enemy.
Yeah, the Lord is really... Yeah, man, I'm laughing because, man, when you go to where our people are at, man, you can see that they're wounded, man. You can see it. Even when you go to Brazil, you can see it, man. Damn. Lord jacked us up really, really bad, but the Lord is going to recover our people. He's still going to have mercy on our people and you know, recover us, man. You know what I mean? And he's going to destroy these other nations that did us wrong. Go ahead. And I think that's it on that. Go back to Matthew 24.
Matthew 34, verse 34. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass until all these things be fulfilled.
Now we're going back to the prophecies. Now we're going back to what Yahweh Shai said. Now it says that this generation or this time period should not pass away until all be fulfilled. In other words, the prophecies, the destruction, the temptation, all of that's going to come to pass. Go ahead.
They say, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away.
And so heaven and earth is speak, you know, really what that's talking about, because it tells you in the scripture, in Ecclesiastes, it says that the earth is going to remain. The word of the Lord is always going to remain, so to speak, you know what I'm saying? So that's what that's kind of, that's what that's talking about. Read that part again.
Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass to all these things be fulfilled.
Go ahead.
Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away.
Yeah, so the Lord's word won't pass away. This Bible is not going to pass away. Now, you got a lot of different other books and religions out there. All of that stuff is going to perish, man. Like your Islam, your Buddhist, your what else, man, you got out there? Yeah, you got your Islam, your Buddhist, and then you got the what else you got, man? You have
Zoroastrianism.
What's that again?
Zoroastrianism.
Zoroastrianism, and there's the Egyptian Book of the Dead, and there's another book I'm thinking about too. What's that? The Hebrew Brotherhood and all that. And I'm thinking about another book that the Mormons use. That I made mention of, they're gonna be done away with, man. All these different ideologies and religions, they're gonna be done away with. But this Bible, the word of Yahweh Shai, is gonna always remain. Go ahead.
I say, for of that day and hour knoweth no man. No, but the angels of heaven.
Yeah, so I mean, we don't really know when the end is going to come from the same. We don't officially know that, but you can sort of know based on the prophecies. As we can get the apocalypse, get the second Ezra's. I believe the second Ezra's, second Ezra's 9. I'll tell you what I think is going to come. You all right, yeah?
Second Ezra chapter 9, verse 1.
Yeah.
He answered me then and said, measure down the time diligently in itself.
But how do we measure the time diligently in itself? How do we do that? Should we just sit on our asses and watch EastEnders all day? The Desperate Housewives show? No. What we do is we look out for news articles, we watch the news, we see what's happening around the world. That's how we measure the time in itself. Okay, because as we're watching the news, what are we seeing? We're seeing people riling up, we're seeing people complain about the injustice of society and other things of that matter. And also on top of that, we're seeing the prophecies come to pass. Go ahead.
And when thou seest part of the sands passed, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time.
We're meeting together.
Says he also be dead and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself.
Go ahead.
And when thou seest part of the signs past, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
Right. So when we see the signs that's happening around us, when we see the signs that are spoken of in his Bible, from Matthew even unto the Apocrypha, okay? When we see these different things happen, like the protesting and all of that stuff, and the outcry amongst the people, and other things of that matter, that's when we know what time we're at. We're at the ending of the so-called white man system, the ancient, the revival of Rome. Okay, we're at the ending of the civilization. We're at the ending of this world. Okay, read that again up.
There it says, therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, then shall the world understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning.
Right, so that's what we're seeing now. We're seeing the cries, the outcries, and the uproars of the people. Like I said before, what are we seeing in this world? You know, we're seeing people that have jobs on them to strike. All right, you have nurses that work in NHS that's going on a strike, protesting, crying out for the injustice that's going on. So when you see the uproars of the people and all of these different signs, then know that the end is not nigh. Know that the end is nigh, excuse me. And we're living at the end. And we're gonna start seeing more severe things happen. Hell, the economy might even collapse this year. We got a lot of economists, experts, or scholars that are saying the same thing, that the economy is soon to crash. Okay? So we know we're dead at the door. We know we're dead at the ending of this world right here. Because a lot of you people, a lot of you think that this is not an empire. But this is an empire. I got news for you. It's a temporal world. It's not going to last very long. It's got little time left on it. Go ahead.
Say, for like as all that is made in the world at a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest, even so, the times also of the highest have plain beginnings in wonders and powerful works.
Okay, read up a verse up.
For like as all that is made in the world.
So like as all that's made in the world
have a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest.
Absolutely. So the ending of the civilization is gradually showing itself to be so. It's being made manifest, man. Like, for example, you're born into this world and then you die at an old age. Okay? Everything comes on this earth and it has an end. Just like all these ancient empires. You had the Babylonian Empire, which started from around 609 BC and ended from and lasted only 67 years. Lasted from 609 BC to 542 BC, okay? So that empire came in effect and it fell, okay? Even the ancient Egyptians came up in effect and fell, okay? Ancient Rome came up in effect and fell. So liking on this empire right here, it rose up and now it's going to fall, and we're seeing the fall of it. We're seeing the economy going down the drain. We've seen people complaining about the amount of money they're making. Protesting. All of that stuff. So we gotta get out of the shop.
Let's see. Even so, for that, as all that is made in the world.
Okay, go ahead.
Have a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest.
Read it one more time,
were light as all that is made in the world have a beginning and an end.
So light as all that is made in the world have a beginning and an end. Go ahead.
And the end is light.